Welcome to the third part of the presentation on divided times. In part 1 and 2, we have seen how literature has always given a voice to the oppressed and the marginalized, referred to as the other. Michelangelo gives the example of four classical works of literature to show that they are all very much modern or postmodern. When analyzed from a 21st century perspective, their heroes turn out to be anti-heroes. We have seen how Homer's Odysseus, Shakespeare's Hamlet and Cervantes' Don Quixote become anti-heroes. In this presentation, we shall see how Goethe's Werther become an anti-hero and also the relevance and necessity of literature in the modern world where issues like refugee crisis are very much rampant. Werther as an anti-hero. The protagonist in Goethe's novel, The Sorrows of Young Werther, is a young man, Werther, hopelessly in love with Charlotte, who is referred to as Lotte, the wife of another man, Albert. Werther is fed up of life in the city and goes to the countryside and he meets the beautiful Charlotte there. He falls in love with her even though she is engaged to Albert. When she does not return his love, he leaves to the city again. Werther is dissatisfied and once again returns to the countryside. Upon being rejected by Charlotte again, he commits suicide. Werther is looked after by Charlotte and her husband Albert in the last hours of his life. He is buried under a tree without proper funeral rites. Werther is an anti-hero because he is a hopeless romantic who does not respect the institution of marriage or fidelity. He is, in that sense, even antisocial. He does not have self-respect or dignity and wallows in self-pity. Finally, he commits suicide and his death and funeral is one of dishonor. He was a victim of unhealthy passion. Thus, he does not have any heroic qualities. He is an anti-hero and hence deeply modern. Let us quickly summarize what we've discussed so far. Literature has always celebrated anti-heroes who in the real world are often marginalized. To explain this, Michelangelo has taken examples of four authors: Homer, Shakespeare, Cervantes and Goethe. Homer is a Greek author, Shakespeare the English author, Cervantes Spanish and Goethe German author. The works are respectively Odyssey, Hamlet, Don Quixote and The Sorrows of Young Werther. The heroes or anti-heroes, when analyzed from a 21st century perspective, are Odysseus in the work Odyssey, Hamlet in the work Hamlet, Alonso Quijano, who takes the name of Don Quixote later on in the novel Don Quixote, Werther in the novel The Sorrows of Young Werther. Now, the reason why these particular evergreen characters are characterized as anti-heroes is because Odysseus is, in effect, a refugee. Hamlet was deeply indecisive. Don Quixote was mad. He believed he was a knight. And Werther had unhealthy passion. All these reasons qualify these characters as anti-heroes. That is, they do not possess the usual idealistic qualities which are associated with heroes. Because of this reason, all these characters are deeply modern. Odysseus is a filthy sailor. Hamlet sees ghosts and is indecisive. Don Quixote is mad and Werther is ruled by unhealthy passion. In real life, such people might be marginalized by the society. But literature does not avoid or oppress such people who are different from the majority. In fact, literature incorporates difference and celebrates it. Literature thus proves to us that anyone can be a hero. A true hero dares to be different and will fight for his freedom. Just like Stephen Dedalus, the protagonist and anti-hero in James Joyce's novel, A Portrait of the Artist as a Young Man. Stephen Dedalus is a young man who dares to reject societal structures to attain his personal and artistic freedom. Thus, we can say that literature makes us better individuals. It broadens our understanding of the other. It enables us to sympathize, understand, appreciate, and accept them. Science and conventional academic education can only give theoretical descriptions about everything. But literature or novels teach us through examples and identification. That is, literature provides us examples and we, the readers, identify with the characters and the situations discussed in those novels. Literature provides many examples of human nature: happiness, sadness, jealousy, anger, guilt, etc. We identify with these examples and in turn develop better understanding. When education loses its quality because of a lack of imagination or money, the more we need literature to teach us about humanity. By reading emblematic works of the European literary tradition, we unconsciously develop a radical understanding of the other or the marginalized. For example, Homer's Odysseus, Daniel Defoe's Robinson Crusoe, Michael Tournier's Friday, etc. represent the refugees all over the world. Crusoe is a castaway who has to spend 28 years on an island away from home. Tournier's Friday is the character in his novel Friday or the Other Island, which is a retelling of Defoe's Robinson Crusoe. If literature does not give representation to the refugees, then the mass media will take over and propagate wrong and violent images of the refugees. Mass media portrays refugees as a threat, as people who have come to scare the West. Only literature can show them in the light of humanity. Thus, literature transforms the unnecessary fear and hatred associated with the others into understanding and acceptance. It makes us better human beings. Thank you.